Wallowing in a dry hollow helps get rid of parasites before they settle in their thick fleece. The herd seems nervous today. Perhaps they've caught a whiff of puma. Daylight hunts are rarely successful, but this hungry puma is willing to take a chance. Her loose stomach is a sign that she's recently given birth. She needs to eat more to produce enough milk. The puma is lucky, scoring a kill close to where she hid her cubs. They instinctively stay under cover until they hear her call. Once she eats her fill, she does her best to hide the carcass, so she can save the rest for another meal. Mother and cubs retreat to the woods to spend the afternoon. She can use a rest. The cubs are always raring to go. Trees are uncommon in this section of the park, and the grove is home to other families too. A Chilean flicker is raising a brood of chicks. Fortunately for all these new mothers and their young, it's a time of plenty in Torres del Paine. The animals take advantage of it while they can. Even the fox, usually active at night, is out and about in broad daylight. When she gets home, there's always a warm welcome. Her five cubs are growing fast, and it's up to her to make sure the milk keeps flowing by keeping herself well fed. For the guanacos, there are other priorities besides eating. The mating season is beginning, and males are eager to show who's boss. There's only room for one dominant male in the herd. Rivals fight for the job. There's a lot at stake. The winner gets to claim the herd's females as his harem and pass on his genes to the next generation. The loser must be on his way. Now the dominant male can get down to business. Her scent tells him she's ready to mate, but she won't make it too easy. When she drops to the ground, he knows she's willing. Sex among guanacos can be a brief affair. If their timing is off, things can get a little awkward. While the lead male tends to his duties, other members of the herd stand guard. Night is not far off, and night always brings danger. At the edge of the woods, the puma rests. She needs her strength for the rigors of the hunt. For the cubs, nap time is over, and they're ready for more games. Tree climbing comes naturally to pumas, as it does to most cats. But figuring out how to get back down takes practice. A Magellanic horned owl is not impressed with their skills. The third cub has other interests. Climbing is kid stuff. She's practicing the grown-up art of stalking. But owls are not easy prey. By late afternoon, the guanaco herd is growing edgy. This is when the puma begins to prowl. She's a master hunter, controlling a territory that could take in more than 100 square kilometers. But every hunt is a gamble, and she can't always get what she wants. The key to success is stealth, especially in daylight, with the guanacos on alert. She must not only surprise her prey, but keep any other animals from raising the alarm. The puma would normally hide her kill while she fetches her cubs, but it has already attracted attention. She takes a chance. though she knows the scavengers will arrive as soon as she leaves. And they do. The guanaco weighs about 100 kilograms. There should be plenty left when she gets back. The crested caracara is first on the scene. But it's a timid bird and soon retreats, allowing the fox to take over. Caracaras may be cousins of hawks and falcons, but they're not much for hunting or fighting off a fox. Under cover of darkness, the rightful owner of the kill returns to reclaim her prize. Once she's confident the coast is clear, she calls her cubs to supper. At 2 months old, they're nearly weaned, graduating from mother's milk to a share of her kills. And young pumas quickly acquire a taste for meat. Even at the rate they're eating, this big guanaco could feed the family for 2 or 3 days, if they can keep it from scavengers. The mother puma knows when they've had enough. But the cubs, always ravenous, need reminding. For them, a break from eating is another chance to play. Their mum isn't interested. Hunting and feeding have left her exhausted. They'll depend on the leftovers for their next meal. It's not easy to hide such a big carcass, but she worked too hard to lose it all to scavengers. Now it's time to go. They need to find a secluded spot where the cubs will be safe, and she can regain her strength for the next hunt. The craggy peaks of Torres del Paine are home to condors, one of the region's top scavengers. And that's unfortunate for the puma. With their sharp eyes, death rarely escapes the condor's notice. Karakaras are already hard at work on the puma's kill. But their meal will soon come to an end. Condors are big and powerful, with an enormous wingspan, more than 3 meters. Now the carcass is theirs. And with so many gathering at the feast, there will be nothing left for the pumas when they return. But condors are skittish birds. Any disturbance can distract them from feeding or throw them into a panic. But it's hard to take off uphill, especially on a full stomach. Condors need a lot of lift under their big wings. They return to the safety of their rookeries to wait for their next opportunity. This is the opening the Karakaras were waiting for. The fox doesn't want to miss her chance either. It's a nice change from her usual diet of rodents and rabbits. Once she eats her fill, the Karakaras can come back for seconds. Like the puma and the fox, the birds have their own young ones to feed. Karakara chicks are always hungry, and their parents aren't great hunters. Having fresh meat available makes life a lot easier. Only the puma can take down an adult guanaco. But the big cat's hunting skill provides a windfall for many of its neighbors. It can spell the difference between survival and starvation. For the guanacos, the best way to survive is to stay on guard. It's autumn now, when they gather in large herds. Sentinels are deployed at every vantage point. They depend on their keen senses to detect the puma before she has a chance to strike. After losing her last kill to scavengers, the puma is risking another daylight hunt. Her cubs are growing fast, and she's the family's only hunter. To hide her scent, she stalks into the wind. And the steady autumn breeze covers the sound of her approach. But with so many eyes surveying the landscape, the puma is usually spotted. Once the sentinels sound the alarm, the game is up. Every animal within earshot